Hello, welcome to Ekidel. We are training for just civil and structural engineering. My name is Justice Omoka and I am your instructor. Today, I'll be showing you the part 15, which is the structural design of this 16-story hotel building, as you can see right here. So on this part 15, we will be walking through the structural design. Specifically, on the part 14, we did the structural analysis, and then to now begin the structural design, we will now have to go to the place that called analysis tab here, and then you can now see that our building analysis is already marked good because we have already done that on the part 14. So if maybe you missed that or this is your first time on our channel, I would advise you can watch the previous parts of this video, okay, and others. So once you click on that place that says analysis tab here, and then we will now come on building analysis here. We will now come here that says analysis here. As you can see that we have already performed the building model check. That's why you can see good here. And we have also performed the building analysis here. As you can see the date that this building analysis was performed. Analysis date was performed 22nd of November 2023 around 3:24 a.m. in the morning. Is it? Okay, so right now you can see that we have now, we will now move on to the structural design. So to perform the structural design, I'll have to click here. Now, mind you, I am using the code, EuroCode, which is the UK annex for my design. So I'm using EuroCode 2, EuroCode 3, and EuroCode 1 for my structural design, which is for loading, for steel, and also for reinforced concrete design. So right now, I'll now come here and then click on this place that says building analysis here. And then I'll wait for it to show the dialog box, and once it shows, I'll just check my columns, my beams, and all that. Okay, so right now, since that's not shown, I'll have to now click on this place here that says what? Column and wall reinforcement design and beam reinforcement design, and I'll have to come here and check with red bar and with red bar if they are if the lowest bar that we choose, chapter 16, is not sufficient, if you choose the higher bar for that. Okay. Now once you have checked that right now, I will now click on this place here that says building analysis. Now, since we have already performed building analysis stage, it will skip that stage and then continue from the design of the column, beams, wall, and other alpha slab too. So right now I'll come here and then click on the thing that says building analysis here, and then wait for it to now continue with the structural design, because it's already done with the building analysis. Okay, so let's just hold on for that to finish up. Okay. So if you have not subscribed to our channel, I would say that you should do that just now so that you don't miss amazing videos up like this. Okay, here on Ekidel we teach structural design and also civil engineering designs to the fullest. Okay, so that you will not be able to miss that, and also give this video a thumbs up so that you don't miss amazing videos too. And if you have not turned on your video or on your channel notification, just click on the different bell and then turn on your video notification, that you will also be notified whenever we post videos like this. Okay, so let's just hold on right now for it to finish up checking the member connectivity. Now once this stage is being completed, it will just move on to the building design directly. Okay. Okay, so right now you cannot see that it is now trying to perform the structural design. Currently, it is now trying to do the span load calculation for all that, which is to transfer the load of the slab onto the beam. It's not trying to calculate the beam load, so it is trying to transfer the load of the slab onto the beam. So let us hold on for that to finish up, which is the span load calculation. Okay, let us hold on for that to complete, and once it's done with that, it will now move on to the beam design properly, where it will have to design all the beams based on the floors, starting from the story 1 all the way down to the last floor, which is the story 16. Okay, so right now you cannot see that the beam load is already being calculated, and which took around 14.87 seconds to calculate the beam load. Okay, and then it is now trying to now check the center of gravity of the story, and also the center of inertia, which is the mass of the story. And then you can see that it's now performing the beam design and all that. Now it is trying to transfer the load from the slab onto the beam. Okay, just hold on for that to finish up. It's currently on story 8, and then it's now moving on to story 9, and then also story 10 and story 11, and then move on to story 12, and then to story 13, and also right now 14, and then 15, and the last and not the least 16, and then the last final 17. Okay, and then it is now trying to now check out for the finite element methods to create the finite element method for this slab. Okay, so this is what it's trying to do right now. So let's just hold on for that to finish up just now. Okay, so you can see now that the column and wall reinforcement design is completed, as you can see. So I will urge you that once you begin to perform the structural design and analysis, give it some time to finish up, because it will take some time, like 20 minutes or thereabouts, to complete the building structural design. So make sure you give it some time. Make sure you don't click any other place once this design process is been on. So make sure you don't click, else the software might shut down or show a one-time error. So just give it some time for it to finish up. Okay, so because of this, now I'm going to pause this video, because it is still left with to move on to the beam design, because what it just finished up now is the column and wall reinforcement design. So it will now have to begin the beam reinforcement design for each of the stories. Okay, so that will take additional like 10 minutes. So just to reduce this video duration for this video, I will have to skip it. I will have to pause this video recording and then continue again once it's about to finish up for the beam design. Okay, so see you then there.
Okay, so right now, as you can see, we are done with the beam design. So I will have to now go here now and then click on close. Okay, so with this now, once you're done with your beam design, the first thing you are going to go to is to go and check the status of your design. And that is called visual interrogation. So right now on this place, to see that, I'll have to go to the place that says display, and then from this display tab here, I'll now have to come here and then click on what, visual interrogation here, and from this place now, I'll now go to the place that says design status here, and then click here. Okay, now once you click here right now, you will see the number of members that is failing, and the one that is okay, and all that, based on the warnings. Okay, okay, so as you can see right now, almost all our members are showing green, except some parts of the column. As you can see, the columns that is carrying the pool here are failing. So what we have to do is to go and check the reason why it is failing. And also, if you check, okay, here also below here, we also have some members that is failing and all that. So although that's not an issue, we will just have to check on that and then check why it is failing and all that. Then also, you can also see that most of our beams are showing, I think they are showing green. Let me just go and then go to the plan view so that I can see my beams very well. So if I go right now and then go to the beam here, and then to the floor plan here, go back again and check on this place again to see how my beams are behaving. Okay, then check here. Okay, you can see that most of our beams are showing not designed. So this is not an issue actually, because we are going to check why it is not designed and all that. So right now, to now check our beams and all that, knowing that all the columns are okay except some part which we are going to check, we have to now come here, click on to now perform beam design. So I'll have to come to this place that says design here. And from this place now, I will not say design all, because I've already designed the columns and all that. So I'll come here and then say story beams here. Story beams. Although I can still do that directly from this place here by clicking here, by click here, and then I'll say beam design here. If I click this for active story, it will just design the beams on this story, but I want to design the entire beam on the structure. So I'll come here and then click on this one that says here, and I will see beam design here. Now from this place right now, I'll wait for it to shoot the next dialog box. So from that place now, we'll now have now okay, so you can see that almost all the beams here are failing. They're not failing, but they are not yet designed. So right now I'll have to now come here and click on this place that says batch design, beam design batch mode. So I'll click on this place here right now, and then come here and then say reset bar if any failure. You can see that reset all bars if there is failure. So I'll come here right now and then click on what, calculate here. Okay, so I'll say yes. I'll say yes, we design. So just wait for it now to now begin to design the beam based on the axis and all that. So wait for it to perform the beam design, okay, and all that. So let me hold on for it to start counting. So let's just hold on for to see that that's start counting and all that. Okay, so as you can see right now, the beams are still counting. As you can see that it says that they're designing, as you can see there here too. So let's just hold on for it to finish up and all that, okay. So let's just hold on for it to complete. So like you can see that most of them now is also taking design. Although even if your members are showing green, your columns, your beams, your wall, and everything is showing green, you are meant to go and perform what they call interactive design. That is for you to discuss with the software to see the kind of members that was used to see the kind of bars that was used to pass your members, either for your beams and columns. And then if the sizes of the bars are not okay, you can choose to change it. So always make sure you perform what they call interactive design after you're done with the design. That will give you enough confidence, and then you'll be sure of what the software is giving. All right, okay, so let's just hold on for it to perform the design purely for the beam and all that. Then we'll now go into the full model of that design status. Now note that slab does not show green. All right, okay, slab doesn't show green, so slab always show something like a gray color. That's the color of a slab and all that. But for columns and your beams, your columns and your beams and your wall must not show red or must show green. And even if everything is showing green, you must still check all your members to see the kind of bars that was used to design that member, either the column or the beam or the wall, as I've said before. Okay, now if you're new on Ekidel, I would suggest you should click on the subscribe button and give this video a thumbs up so that we'll also go viral here on YouTube. And also, if you are working, and also if you're a student, I would say you should share our videos to your friends and also to your colleagues, so that they also know what's happening here on Ekidel. Ekidel is a platform where we train future civil and structural engineers and help them to build their career and all that. Okay, now if you check on our bio, you can see our store, online store. Just click on that and then get all the softwares that we are using for our design, just like Stonebridge Template, KCSoft, which is for the staircase, and then we also have some courses here on our online store, so they can get that course on history building and get the course on church auditorium building design and all that. Then we also have what they call Ekidel mentorship class. So if you want to enhance or know more about social design, I would advise you enroll for our Ekidel mentorship class. And after the 6 weeks of the training, your life will not even be the same. Then also, we are also introducing a new structural engineer that will be teaching basically structural detailing. So from the 1st of December 2023, you will begin to see the videos, and then you will also begin to see a new instructor here on Ekidel platform. And there is also what we call Ekidel WhatsApp Global Group. So if maybe you want to interact with other engineers around the world, I would advise you just click on the link below and join the Ekidel WhatsApp group free of charge. That's not a payment, but when it comes for the Ekidel mentorship class, that is a payment and it's not really expensive. That's around $480, which is not really expensive compared to what you are going to gain at the end of the training. And also at the end of the training, we are also going to issue to you what they call certificates and all that. So you also get certificate at the end of the training. So that's why I advise you get it, you like enroll for the training and all that. Okay, let's just wait on for this video right now to complete, and then we'll just move on to the next. Now, if you have any comment, I would say you should click on the comment down below and all that, and then we'll also reply you at SAP. Okay, so let me just look for it to finish up right now, and then we'll now move on to now begin to check our members, our beams, our column, and all that, one after the other, story by story, and all that. Now, if you have not followed this video from the part one, and if you are new on this particular video, I would say this video have the part one up to this very part 14 and all that. So I would say it's just click on the link down below and download the CAD file so that you are able to follow up all the video. The CAD file is not free and it's very, very cheap for you to get that. The reason why I say you should get the CAD file so that you can be able to follow up this video and all that. This video is really, really an amazing video. If you are able to get to this point, I would say that you are already 20% good as a structural engineer. Okay, so right now, I'll just hold on for that to finish up right now and then come back to the next once this is done. Okay, so right now you can now see that it's done with the beam design. So right now, you can see that it's saying here, process completed. I will now come here and then click on what close. Now, if you can click our beam here, I can see that most of the beams have been designed, like are passing, and most of the beams are showing red. The one showing red, maybe the size of the beam is not sufficient to carry the load. So we will now have to go and check why that is happening. So right now, I'll just come here and then close this other one here. And then you can now see that now, from this service, you can see that most of the beams are passing. And if you also go to our 3D view here, you will also see that the beams right now, most of them are passing and all that. So right now, even if they are passing, like I said, you will still have to check your structure, check your members after the other. So right now, let's now begin with the story one. So right now, I'll just go all the way down now and then make my story one to, okay, the one is already active. So I will go to the plan view of story one and all that. So right now, you can see that most of our beams here are passing, but let's begin with the column first. Why the columns are failing. Let me start with this column here. Let me just go right now. Click on this one right now. Right click here. And so, whenever your column is failing, the first thing you do is to come here and then click on what they call, click on the column and then click on session design and all that, okay? But basically, this part of what they call, this part of us checking the structure would be on the part 15, because this video, this part 14 is already up to 15 minutes and I don't want it to be more than that so that it can get boring. So I'll begin the checking of the columns and the beams on the part 15. So the part 15, we will like focus on what? Interactive design, okay? So but let me just show you how to open up your column when it's fading. So click on that and then you see the data box right now. You can see that it's fading. So if I go here and then click on the design here, I will see the reason why it's fading. There will be a warning here why it is fading, although I will show you that more on the part what 15. Okay, so you can see that it said that section bar cannot be selected, section size must be increased. That means that the size of the column is not sufficient. Okay, so we need to increase the size, although there are some things that you are meant to do before you can increase the size, which I'll show you on the part 14. Okay, no, sorry, on the part 15. Okay, so right now I will say cancel because I want to show you that on the part 15 of the video. Okay, so you can see how we have performed the structural design for this 16 story building having a swimming pool at the top here. Okay, so on the part 15 right now we'll be basically on interactive design, where we'll have to check each of the members starting from story 1 all the way down to the last floor here and check all the members and make sure that everything is okay, even the one that is fading and the one that is showing green. You must check them to know the kind of bar sizes reinforcement that the software is giving to you, so that you don't have your drawing being messed up at sight during the construction. Okay, so right now I'll be going off right now and then see you again on the part 15. So God bless you and see you again there. Bye for now.